this is a very special episode because it's just what's on tap.
Because there's so much on tap that we need to talk about it, and that's the only thing we can talk about.
Yep, that's right. And in part because it's annual meeting weekend this weekend.
Woo!
Yeah, right. Lots of cheers for that. So that is one, the first thing that's on tap, but also is the reason we're not going to do an extended Soulcast, because you'll hear it all on Sunday, truthfully.
Truthfully. And you're going to get to see a lot of quality video editing by the two of us.
Mostly Maggie, just like, let this be on the record. Maggie just worked her tail off this week on this annual meeting video. And I am personally very grateful. And it's cool. So
I think it's going to be super fun.
You get it too. So the biggest thing with annual meeting is you need to register for the Zoom call. We did, however, change because we realized it might be difficult for two people in the same household to be on both be on Zoom so that they can vote. And we're going to make a Google Doc that you can vote of Google form that you'll be voting on Vestry members through. So,
and that Google form will show up in the chat on the Zoom call. So you don't need to look for it anywhere else. It'll show up while we're on the Zoom call, and it's not going to be on the website.
That's right. That also means that you don't need to register separately from people in your household. You can have one registration on Zoom for the Zoom call per household. If I notice that some of you have already registered as separate people, like spouses have registered individually, if you could cancel your registration, that would be great. And if you can't, that's okay. You know that you can be on one screen now. Sorry about the confusion. We're just trying to figure this whole thing out.
We are first ever annual meeting, completely virtual, and you're going to be a part of it. So that's exciting.
So I've got something else on tap, which I'm excited about, which is that Paul Guillory and Tracy Smith, a couple at this parish, have offered their skills and time to lead a small group around partnerships and couples and kind of walking through some questions together. So it's going to be a small group of partnered folks, and they're going to offer their expertise and wisdom, and there'll be a lot of discussion, some book reading. You can find more information in the Pathfinder from last week about that. But if you're interested, you can also just email them directly, and they're going to set that up. It's set to start February 7th. So do register soon if you're interested in doing that with your partner, spouse.
As I remember, it's 6 weeks on the Sundays afternoon,
in a row. That's right. The other one we have is another round of Sacred Ground, which you can sign up for on our website. And you can read an excellent Pathfinder piece by Christine Trost, encouraging us to participate with people from all around the country who maybe don't have access to this, don't have a small group that they can join wherever they are. Christine was really encouraging us to reach across the table with this and see if we can invite someone who doesn't think the way we do, or a family member, a friend that we know who, we can come alongside and do this with alongside of. So, if you are interested in that, you should read her article in the Pathfinder from last week as well. Both of those small groups ran in last week's Pathfinder.
Yeah. I have lots of things on tap for children, youth, and families. The first is, if you missed it 2 weeks ago, we have restarted Zoom youth group, which is a word that I never thought I'd say in my professional career, Zoom youth group, but here we are, mid-pandemic, and that's what we have right now. So we are going to be on Zoom 7 o'clock Sunday evenings. We meet every other Sunday. So this Sunday, the 31st, is our next meeting, and you can find that link in the Google group. I will email it out to you. If you are not in the Google group and you have people in your household who are between grades 6 and 12, please reach out to me, maggie@allsoulsparish.org, and I will make sure that you get included on that list. Then the following day, Monday, February 1st, we are going to have our first of an indefinite amount, depending on how we like it. Happy hour, a Zoom happy hour for our parents. So if you want to ditch the kids for a minute, leave them in the other room, and hop online and just check in with other All Soulsians who have kids who are living through this like weird experience. We're going to do it on the first Monday of the month, beginning at 4:30. The Zoom link for that you can find in the Pathfinder, and you can also find it in the Children and Family Bulletin. If you don't receive that and you would like to, please again reach out to me and I'll add you to that. And then on Wednesday, Kids Book Club is back.
Whoa! And
I'm personally super excited about it. We are going to be reading The Magic in Changing Your Stars, and I chose this book because it looks awesome. And February is Black History Month, and I wanted us to read a book that is about Black characters, and that's what we're doing. We are going to read The Magic in Changing Your Stars. If you haven't heard of it, look it up on Goodreads. It's advertised for grades 8 through 12, or not grades 8 through 12, for ages 8 through 12. But we will be reading aloud to the kids. So if they are not at that reading level, that's fine. And you don't need to own your own copy of the book because, again, we will read it out loud. So if you're interested in being a guest reader for that, I'd love to have you reach out to me as well so we can get that schedule going. And lastly, not this week.
She's still going. Because
of the annual meeting.
She's still going.
I'm still going. I have so many announcements. Not this week because of the annual meeting, but all the subsequent weeks, every Sunday at 10:10, we have Children's Chapel, and that Zoom information is also in the Children and Family Bulletin, and it will be in the Pathfinder, and we're going to try something new for the next several weeks. We're going to do a show and tell. So I know that we've all been trapped in our homes. And so each week I'll send out a prompt or a theme and I'll ask every family to go around their home and find one or two items that relate to that theme and bring them and show and tell the rest of the group. And we'll see how many things we have in common around our homes and how many things we have different. And so I hope that this is a way of reminding us that even though our house might feel like an escape room that we can't escape, at the current moment, there is holiness there, and there is a way to have and create prayerful space and be reminded that God's love for us permeates even the four walls of our home, however chaotic and or lonely it may be. So those are my children family updates. I know that's a lot, and they're all listed in the Pathfinder and in the Children Family Bulletin.
Maggie Foot is in the house, man.
Yeah, you know, I don't know if you're going to want to cut this part later, but I went through like the 3 weeks after Christmas. I was like, this is too much, you know, like I'm so over Zoom and I have no ideas. And I think right now we are just in a season of faithfulness. Like we have to be faithful to showing up for each other. And however that looks for you. And I know that not all of those activities that I mentioned are going to meet every single family that we have, but I'm hoping that there's something in there that will reach your family, parents and kids alike. And we can be faithful to this and just keep showing up for each other the best ways that we know how, or the best ways that we can in this moment. So I'm feeling a little better about it than I was a few weeks ago.
I'm glad to hear that.
Yeah.
And what something you said reminded me too that if y'all don't know how the Pathfinder is structured, I'm going to tell you really quickly so that you can know what to look for. Every week there are four articles that come out. One is always by the lead article, which is usually Maggie or Phil. But then after those four articles, there is a news and notes section. So if ever you're like, I can't find out the Zoom link to this thing or what time this thing is running or the calendar says something, but I can't find it anywhere. You can almost always find it at the very bottom of the Pathfinder in this big news and notes section that has just like all the stuff. So that's just a, so you know, maybe that's a new segment at All Souls on Soulcast.
Just so you know, that I like that idea. That could be a season three segment. And they can be like about anything. It's like, just so you know, this is where we keep the light bulbs.
That's right.
Or like, just so you know, this part of the website is where you go to do this.
Right. It could be anything, really.
Yeah. Yeah. That's awesome.
Sweet. I think this is season two, episode Anyway, all right. Well, all Soulcast, see you next week. No, see you Sunday. Sunday.
Yeah, Sunday.
But Soulcast. Yeah, I have to.
It's a later time of day.
I know our tiredness is going to show again. But yeah, I'm really peppy.
Okay.
Am I editing this week?